There is a song, Moira, that the sea whispers to the land. A song for pilgrims and for babbies going to sleep. Spirit, be with thee on every stream. In the trough of the waves, on the crest of the billows.
You remember it, don't you, Moira?
And when Beltane brings the neap tide home, then you'll be coming back to me.
The hill behind the house 100 times. I know every stone. But after that hill, there's another. And then another again. And after all that, then that's the sea. And I've never been there.
Come to the lighthouse, Moira. Come as fast as you can.
Woohoo!
Oh,
prettier house is called Lan Mull, the Bald Edge. They say this is as far north as the English got before Wallace blunted their blades. Didn't hold them off for long, mind.
What? Been me and my mum together for as long as I can remember. She never let me go anywhere, like she was ashamed of me or something. So I went up into the hills anyway. What?
Uncle Hamish has lived in the lighthouse forever, and he lives there on his own. I thought all the lighthouses were automatic now, but either they don't know about his one, or else he's never noticed the light comes on by itself. Uncle Hamish sends me letters every month or so. When I was little, he'd send me pictures, never photos. Sometimes he'd throw in a shell or a bit of a crab's leg, like he was some kind of wizard.
Thank you.
water keeps smashing away, tearing the hill in two.
What?
atop the hilltop like a crown.
The queen of these hills is Queen Morag the First. She likes to give gifts, but she also likes to receive them. Anything beautiful, she'll take.
Yes!
Now, bairn, and I'll tell it again. Once upon a time, there was a lonely fisherman. The fisherman worked on the Loch Mullerdoch, catching river trout.
Oh. Oh, oh.
Once when I was a bairn, I put a feather on top and it grew into a bird and flew away.
Oh.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Oh.
I can't believe I'm doing this. I must be off my trolley. And an Uncle H's say so too. He's got no trolley and all. The tunnel seems to stretch out in front and behind. It goes on forever, like a bloody poem. My little brother taught me to climb. Kept getting himself stuck up a tree or on a roof. Not like my mum would get her fat arse up there to get him back. When the dark falls over the hills, it's like a veil. You can't see your own hands or feet. You could be shrunk to the size of a mouse or grown as large as a giant, and you wouldn't know. All my life, Uncle H has written me letters, and I wrote him letters in return. Dear Uncle H,
called the Outer Wall. It once was powerful strong, but has fallen to ruin now. And the king's been missing for years.
What? Ha!
Once Hamish sent me a rusty nail from the Titanic. He told me he'd got it from the bottom of the sea. I was 7 years old, so like a total chump, I believed him.
Now the Hill of Toxich is a fine place to stand, but it's no place to linger if you... What do they say up there?
Huh?
Every cairn is a pile of fallen soldiers. One stone placed for every man who went into battle. One stone taken back only by those who returned.
About Uncle Hamish is that he's a total idiot. Not the annoying kind. He's the kind you talk to because you never know what he'll say. But, you know, still an idiot. Come to the sea by Beltane, he said. Something wonderful is coming. And I'm doing it. I'm coming. I must be mental. Oh! Oh. Uncle Hamish writes me letters, but he isn't chatty.
Sea's raging. Wind's up. But I can see all the way to the North Pole, I reckon.
That sort of thing.
Huh.
What?
These lands have always been precious. Always under attack. From the south by the land, and from the east from the sea.
I like it here. Can't we stay here?
No, my love. We can't. But God be with her. In every pass.
Hamish, I can't bear it.
The rain stops, and the air clears. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, oh, oh. Uncle Hamish says he writes his letters and puts the post, he pulls the wire. But where does he get the...
Whoa.
The dam below Leam Lanning was built 100 years ago. They say they needed it because the loch overflowed with the tears of the Jacobites' wives.
Woo-hoo!
The Jacobites were supporters of James II, the White Rose they called him.
Hamish never comes to visit, not even for Christmas. He says he can't leave his post. If that lighthouse of his is automatic, someone really ought to tell him. Roaring torrents like charging horses. Oof.
hills are awash with stories. That's what happens when people are driven out. Their stories get left behind. Stray dogs. With no one to take them in.
Wait.
The wind that blows across these peaks never stops. You can't breathe the same bit of air twice.
Breslin Rock is the highest peak between the outer wall and the high mountains. And it knows it. And it'll make you pay for it too.
Night falls. Sometimes replies would come immediately. Sometimes they'd take months to arrive. Dear Uncle H.
The islands seem empty, Moira, but they weren't always. These valleys are full of echoes. Plenty of ghosts, if you're out by moonlight.
About 2 years ago, a man bought a radio. She thinks it broke, but it didn't. I took it up Lan Mool and discovered music.
I've never done anything but walk. I can feel myself opening out. The way Uncle H says happens when you dump an oyster in a bucket of seawater. I've never seen the sea. I think my mum's afraid of it, but I've dreamt of it. And I know exactly how it sounds and how it feels. No snow yet.
I'm the only one in my family to have green eyes. I know, who cares what colour your eyes are? Only they all have blue eyes. And there's me, with green. My little brother says I'm cursed. My little brother is a little toad.
Thank you. What?
My mum grew up in Inverness. I think her mum must have been Nessie herself.
Winches of the mine below Devil's Tail used to run day and night. There's no daylight in a mine, no reason to sleep. But then the English taxed the mines dry and cleared them out.
The fishermen worked on the Loch Mullardoch, catching river trout. The fisherman of Loch Mullardoch was horribly lonely. So it was the lonely fisherman took a wife, the daughter of a local farmer.
Now the beak isn't a mountain at all. It's the great big nose of a giant, asleeping on his back. Once every 500 years, he sneezes, and the whole land shakes. Everything in this world is a balance of separated things. The sea and the shore, the hills and the valleys, the people you're with and the people you're without. And all you can do is hope for luck as you're finding the gap in between.
Hup!
The rain goes on and on until suddenly it clears.
What?
The last slope to be cleared around here was the slope to the east of Machtala Hreicher. They say the last family to leave cried so loud, you can still hear the echo.
Mom left the city and moved here. I guess because she hates people. But I guess Hamish must be even worse. The woodland is taking the hills back.
Oh!
The tower and peak of the Eagle's Nest is really an honest-to-God volcano. And the last time it exploded, it spat out the Highlands themselves.
My brother Ben and me should have been best mates. Some days we were, but most days I went my way and he'd sat about on his own.
Woohoo!
Lighthouse. There it is. I can do this. I know I can.
Thank you. So it was the lonely fisherman took a wife, the daughter of a local farmer. The farmer was a gigantic hulk of a man, and so was his massive daughter. They said the farmer's daughter could tear up trees with her bare hands, she was so strong.
Woohoo!
is, I won't miss my mum, but I'll miss my brother. He might be a...
Goshawk, love. It's the eyes of the queen. Cover your head.
Oh, 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 oh.
In the winter, people come out here to throw themselves off a mountain. A couple of years ago, my brother Ben got ill. Went into his lungs, they said, and wouldn't he come out. That's when he moved to Edinburgh. Haven't seen him since.
Thank you.
as Ísbjörgjotr, and she flew down from Iceland, feeling terrible cold. She rested inside the mountain, trying to get warm enough to fly again, and the great worm's never been able to escape. They say the dragon Ísbjörgjotr of Eagle's Nest had children, gigantic eagles, that fly down to collect her tears, great lumps of quartz as big as rocks.
Huh.
They said the farmer's daughter could tear up trees with her bare hands, she was so strong. Now, the fisherman and the giant's daughter had themselves a child, a son, the size of a cow. The fisherman's son was a handsome little monster, with a smile like dawn and anger like thunder.
We're going to go visit my brother in hospital. We didn't. Then we was going to visit him at his dad's house. We didn't do that either. Watchtower never saw it coming. Whatever it was.
Uh,
Maybe once I'm back from the lighthouse, then I'll go see how little Ben's getting on. Now, when the wind blows, I'm catching the smell of the sea. Beltane is today. I can do this. I know I can.
Oh.
For my whole life, the lighthouse has marked the edge of my world. Now, I realise that's exactly what it is.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Come in, Hamish. These hills are a prison, and I'm breaking out.
Thank you.
The fisherman's son was a handsome little monster, with a smile like dawn and anger like thunder. One day, the fisherman's monstrous child threw a stone and it hit a bird. But the bird hit by the fisherman's child was no bird. It was, in truth, a baby boobrie.
Hamish is mad, maybe? He didn't say the seals were beaching early at the lighthouse. He said it was the Selkies. Thank you. What?
Thank you.
Uncle H lives in a lighthouse, but... I'd never been. So I built a model and put a candle in the top some nights. Fancied he could see the light across the hills.
The last hill before the sea is Balamara, and she's the guardian of the land. She's what stops the sea itself from marching in, though, by all accounts, she's given in mind.
Oh.
That's it. And wait.
The rain goes.
Come in, Hamish. Yes! I always knew I didn't fit in back home. With my mum, with my brother, I always thought, who am I? Never, what am I?
Thank you.
These hills are awash with stories, Moira. Let me tell you one.
Okay, that'd be nice.
Once, there was a lonely fisherman.
Did he live in a lighthouse, maybe?
Aye, he did.
I thought so.
And he was dreadful lonely. Just him and his fish. So we decided to marry his neighbour's daughter.
Oh, did he now?
Aye, he did, but he shouldn't have. Because she was a brute. Voice like thunder and arms like pitchforks she had. But her son, he was even worse.
I like this story, Hamish. Keep on with it.
Aye, and I will if you'd stop interrupting. Oh, you've got a mouth on you and no mistake.
I have. You're the one who wants to tell his stories all day. You should have your own radio programme.
Well now, there's an idea.